Please be advised that the views and opinions of the host and guests do not reflect those of the station, the management, and its network.
A pleasant and blessed day po sa inyo, mga minamahal naming kahuntahan. Natutuwa po kami na tayo ay muli na naman magkakasama dito sa People's Court, ang natatanging legal show ng GNN na sumasa inyo linggo-linggo. Layunin po namin dito sa People's Court na ipaalam po sa inyo ang mga essentials ng iba't ibang batas para po kayo ay mas lalo pang ma-empower through legal information. Ako po muli si Attorney Al Jumrani at kasama ko po uli ang aking People's Court partner na si Judge Jing Oyenko Norasco. Hi Judge!
Hi Attorney Al at hi din po sa inyong lahat mga kahuntahan. As always, sama-sama, sana po ay lagi po kayong ligtas kung saan man po kayo naroon habang pinapanood nyo ang aming show. Ako po uli si former Judge Jing Oyenko Norasco at welcome po uli sa inyong lahat mga kahuntahan sa isa na namang interesting and information-filled episode ng People's Court na mapapanood nyo tuwing Huwebes at 7 p.m. sa GNN with reruns on our YouTube channel and Facebook page. Hanapin nyo lang po ang GNN People's Court. Please like, subscribe, and share po sa iba para mas marami pa po ang ma-empower through legal information.
At mga kauntahan, kung kayo po ay may mga tanong, comments, or suggestions for further topics, please feel free to send us a message anytime through our FB page, YouTube channel, and also through TikTok and Twitter.
At doon naman po sa mga nagpadala na ng comments, feedback, suggestions, and questions, maraming salamat po sa inyo. Doon po sa mga tanong, please continue to watch each episode of People's Court because as we promised, we will answer and discuss po your questions para na rin po madagdagan ng legal information ng lahat ng viewers ng People's Court.
Salamat po muli mga kauntahan at patuloy niyo pong panoorin ang aming episode para madagdagan po ang kaalaman niyo sa batas. Hindi po kayo magsisisi, promise yan.
Correct, Atty. Al. Mga kahuntahan, bawat episode ay talaga pong pinaghahandaan namin ni Atty. Al. Kasama na rin po ang aming producer at syempre pa ang buong production team ng GNN People's Court. Together, of course, with all of our special guests. Kaya each episode po is truly a product of love, hard work, and the desire to help improve the society through legal information.
Speaking of episodes, mga kauntahan, kung kayo po ay may na-miss na episode ng People's Court o may gusto po kayong ulitin, all episodes of People's Court are uploaded in our YouTube channel. Mm-hmm. And to make our episodes more accessible to you, mga kauntahan, ang mga recent episodes po natin ay available na rin sa FB.
That's right.
Kaya just go to our YouTube channel and FB page, search for the episode that you would want to watch or rewatch and enjoy while learning.
Ayun. And with that, it's now time for our balik tanaw portion.
Yes.
By watching the highlights from our previous episode, you're fired with the very cool and game Dean Ada Abad. Roll BTR.
We have a security of tenure, mm-hmm. or the right to security of tenure under the Constitution. So can you please elaborate on that, yung right to security of tenure?
Yung security of tenure is guaranteed by the Constitution. Ito lang yung karapatan ng tao na manatili sa kanyang trabaho.
Correct.
Okay. Hanggat wala siyang ginagawang bulilyaso against yung kumpanya, no? It's a reasonable, you know, it's the right to reasonably expect that you will remain in employment for as long as you have not committed any act which is prejudicial to the company, no? So until such time as you know that you have not done anything wrong, then you have a right to expect that you will continue working for that company, di ba? Now, kaya sinasabi dyan that, you know, security of tenure, hindi ka pwedeng matanggalan ng trabaho kung walang just authorized cause at saka yung katulad na explain mo kanina without due process. Pero may kulang. Kasi actually nakakalimutan nila yung pangatlong ground, no? So aside from just cause or authorized cause, yung failure to qualify as a probationary employee.
Ayun.
Ang dami na nating na-cover doon, Judge, di ba?
Mm-hmm.
Interesting ang naging discussion natin within Ada, who doesn't want to be called Mommy Ada.
Correct.
And Tita Ada na lang daw.
Tama.
Kaya maraming salamat po uli, Dean Ada. And sana po ay paunlakan niyo po uli ang aming invitation for a future guesting here on People's Court.
Tama ka doon, Atty. Al. At maraming salamat ulit, Dean Ada. And one more, ha? As you said, marami pa tayong dapat i-discuss about labor law. Lalo na nga yung mga topics na na-mention mo, like yung return to work order for those who are currently working from home. Now, Atty. Al, ano naman ang mga pabaon mo sa ating mga kahuntahan from our last episode on the dismissal of employees with Dean Ada?
Thank you, Judge. Actually, malapit sa puso ko ang labor law.
Mm-hmm.
Lumaki ako dyan dahil sa Department of Labor and Employment nagtrabaho ang tatay ko for almost 40 years.
Oh, wow! Talaga?
Yes.
Grabe!
As in, I remember kalahati ng mga libro namin sa mini library namin sa bahay ay labor code at manuals.
Oh.
Yung kalahati naman ay book of knowledge at mga Reader's Digest.
Talaga?
Yes. Okay. So, when Dean Ada spoke about the importance of just or authorized causes and procedural process in termination, naalala ko yung mga kinukwento ng tatay ko sa akin, actual cases na hawak nila.
Mm-mm.
So I think it is important to stress that the law seeks to balance the interest of both labor and capital or yung kapakanan ng mga manggagawa at mga employer.
That's right.
While workers have the right to security of tenure, meron din namang management prerogatives ang mga employers na reasonable at naayon sa kanilang karapatan na kumita.
Tama.
Kaya dapat sundin ng bawat panig ang batas para maging harmonious ang kanilang relasyon. Ikaw naman, Judge.
Well, yung sa akin, Atty. Al, may mga gusto lang akong idagdag tungkol sa naging topic natin last week with Dean Ada na hindi na natin masyado na-cover due to lack of material time. First is with respect to constructive dismissal at actually kaakibat nun yung konting banggit na rin about resignation. Ano nga ba yung constructive dismissal? According to the Bureau of Labor Relations of the DOLE, citing the case of Blue Dairy Corporation versus NLRC, constructive dismissal refers to an involuntary resignation. So parang napilitan lang, no? Resorted to when continued employment becomes impossible, unreasonable, or unlikely. O kaya naman, when there is a demotion in rank or diminution in pay or yung binawasan yung bayad. Or when there's a clear discrimination, insensibility, or disdain by any employer, no, that which sa ang dating nun sa employee unbearable na sa kanya. So katulad nung may unwarranted transfer o kaya naman demotion of an employee or kahit yung iba pang unjustified action na prejudicial or nakakasama dun sa empleyado. The employer, pagka ganun kasi, the employer has to prove that such managerial actions do not constitute constructive dismissal. Ano ang test sa constructive dismissal? Whether a reasonable person in the employee's position would have felt compelled or yun nga, napilitan to give up his employment or position under the circumstances. In other words, ang constructive dismissal is dismissal in disguise.
Ay, maskara.
Oo. Nag-resign si employee hindi dahil gusto niya talaga yun, kundi parang no choice na siya. Hence, while constructive dismissal has been held to be not illegal dismissal, pero pag may finding po ng isang empleyado pala ay constructively dismissed from employment, ang epekto nun sa employer ay similar doon sa epekto sa illegal dismissal. And that is, yung employer po may be held liable for reinstatement with full back wages or kung hindi na posible ang reinstatement dahil na rin sa strained relations between the parties, kumbaga hindi na sila po pwede talagang magsama, di ba? Then to separation pay, kapalit ng reinstatement, in addition to full back wages.
Ako, Judge, parang yung further discussion on constructive dismissal and resignation from employment, mukhang kailangan natin ng separate episode on that, Judge. What do you think?
Oo, tama ka doon, Atty. Al, kasi marami pa talagang pwedeng pag-usapan tungkol sa topic na yan. No? Iba-iba yung mga lumalabas sa decision ng Supreme Court. Of course, depending doon sa facts of the case. We can even relate it doon sa isa pang topic na sinabi ni Dean Ada regarding the return to work order for those in a work from home scheme. Paano kung yung empleyado refuses to comply, no? And was asked to resign from employment by the company? And the kung nag-comply si employee, can the employee later on validly claim that he or she was constructively dismissed? Pwede yan. Kaya Atty. Al, mukhang ang mainam na ka-partner ng ating You're Fired na episode is I resign. O, di ba?
Ay, o nga, Judge. Parang partner episodes nga yun. No?
Mm-hmm.
In fact, mainit na balita ngayon yung return to work order lalo na sa business process outsourcing o BPO industry dahil kamakailan sinabi ni Finance Secretary Sunny Dominguez na kailangan nang bumalik sa office ang mga BPO workers.
Correct.
So that these BPO companies can continue to enjoy their tax perks and incentives.
Mm-hmm.
Kaya mga kauntahan, watch out for that episode.
Yun, tama po, watch out for that. But in the meantime, and before we go to our topic reveal, mm-hmm. may gusto akong itanong sa iyo, Atty. Ni Al. Yan. Kamusta naman ang Boracay vacation mo? Baka kwentong, konting kwento naman para na rin sa ating mga kahuntahan.
Judge, ito lang sasabihin ko. What happens in Boracay stays in Boracay.
Aba, ganon, may ganon. Parang marami,
naintriga
ako sa'yo. Ay,
wish ko lang, sana may nangyari, di ba wala naman. Kaya ako pumunta doon para may mangyari. Joke lang. Sorry po, censor. Okay, well, ito, resibo na pagpunta ko sa Boracay, sunog.
Ay, ayan. Hindi naman.
Ay, di ba? Ayan, magaling kasi ating makeup artist. Ayan, nagawa ng paraan ng makeup. But really, I love the sun, sand, and surf. Mm-hmm. Kaya no complaints.
Mm-hmm.
Masaya ang 5-day vacation ko doon, actually. Masigla na ulit ang turismo and it's, you know, very nice to see. Marami mm-hmm. na rin tao. In fact, no, na-meet ko doon, dalawang nag-take ng bar exam nitong February.
Mm-hmm.
Isang kababayan from Zamboanga at isang kasamahan natin sa legal profession.
Nice.
Yung dalawang nag-bar exam, nakasama ko pa sa island hopping.
Oh.
No, magkasama kami sa Bangkok. Kaya sabi ko, sino itong tumitin sa akin? And ako conscious. At saka nakasama ko rin sila. Well, of course, after meeting them,
mm-hmm.
we had a Mexican dinner.
Ah, nice.
Nakalimutan ko anong name. Pero yun. Mm-hmm. Doon kami. And then si prosecutor naman, nagpag-dinner mm-hmm. din ako with his beautiful fiance.
Okay.
Kaya advance congratulations sa inyo. Mm-hmm. Indeed, no, you really won't know who you'll bump into in Boracay.
Wow, yes. Parang napakasarap nung iyong experience sa Boracay. Kaya lalo tuloy ako na-excite sa upcoming trip ko rin sa Boracay, malapit na rin. Kasi yun nga, share ko lang up to 2018. Actually, parang every year nagpupunta kaming Boracay. Mula pa nung 1-year-old pa lang yung panganay ko, si Barry. Lalo na nung anong buhay pa si husband ko kasi talagang, yun, part yan ng annual vacation namin. Annual
yes,
tradition na pumunta sa Boracay. Pero yun na nga, nakakasenti. Kaya bago pa ako maiyak, baka magkaiyakan tayo dito.
Oo.
Mag-topic reveal
correct,
na tayo, Atty.
Kasi
ni
kung iyak ka dyan, sasabayan talaga kita, Judge.
Oo nga, mag-drama na tayo.
Sige, Judge, mga kauntahan, ang episode namin today ay alay namin sa ating mga viewers from the LGBTQ community.
Yan.
Marami po sa inyo ang nag-suggest ng topic na ito. Kaya talaga pong pinaghandaan namin ito at nag-imbita kami na isang special guest who can really do justice in discussing this topic with us today.
Mm-hmm.
Mga kauntahan, pag-uusapan po natin ngayong araw ang mga karapatan ng mga miyembro ng LGBTQ plus community.
That's right, Atty. Al. Marami talaga nag-aabang ng episode na ito. Kasama na ron yung tita ko, si Tita Vanjie, na talaga nagpa-follow up ng episode na to.
Mm-hmm.
Kaya nga sabi ko sa kanya, yung shout-out ko sa kanya will be in this particular episode. Kaya hi, Tita Vanjie! Ito na ang episode na hinihintay mo.
Hi po, Tita Vanj. So, yun na ba ang shout-out mo, Judge? O, so, ako na ba?
Actually, meron pa. Pero sige, mauna ka na. Mamaya na yung iba.
Okay, sorry. Akala ko yun lang. Di ba, para okay maiba lang. Naman, sana isa lang ang batiin. Para mas marami ako.
Hoy, dati isa lang binabati ko. Sige, ikaw na.
Okay, halata ba? Excited ako sa shout-out. Anyway, thanks, Judge. At binabati ko po yung na-meet ko nga sa Boracay, sina Atty. Chin and Joe Mar, Prosecutor Rainier and his fiancé, and lastly, si Robert Llamas Marquez, kasama ng kanyang mom and aunt, at ang mga Llamas, Marquez, Sudario, at Palo families ng FB Harrison sa Pasay City. Nice meeting you all sa Boracay. Judge?
Ako na ulit. O yan. Hello po sa mga binati ni Atty. Al at mag-hi na lang po ako ulit sa mga taga-UP Law IAJ, lalo na po kina Atty. Armand, Ate Mabel, Ate Evelyn, Rona, Kuya Ariel, Rafi, Joe, and Rolly. May nakalimutan ba ako? Naku, kung meron po, pasensya na next time ulit. See you all soon!
And that wraps up our Huntahan segment. Mamaya naman sa ating Legally Speaking segment, bukod sa pagbibigay ng overview tungkol sa topic natin for today, may mga ilang tanong din tayong sasagutin mula sa ilan nating mga kahuntahan.
Kaya abangan nyo po yan, mga kahuntahan. Stay tuned! Yan ay sa pagbabalik ng
People's Court.
The information provided in this show does not and is not intended to constitute legal advice. Instead, all information and content in this show are for general informational purposes only. No viewer should act or refrain from acting on the basis of information provided in this show without first seeking legal advice from a proper counsel. No attorney-client relationship is created or intended to be created with the audience of the show.
Welcome back to People's Court, to our Legally Speaking segment. This is again your Kuya Attorney Al, kasama ang inyong Ate Judge Jing.
Yun. Now, Attorney Al, it's time to answer some questions from our kahuntahan sa pinadala nila via DM or direct message to our Facebook page. Mm-hmm. Of course, we got their consent and they agreed. And yun nga, sabi natin sa kanila, sasagutin natin yung mga tanong nila dito sa ating show, no? Para na rin sa legal information ng lahat ng ating mga kahuntahans. At ulitin ko lang po, hindi po ito meant to be a legal advice, no? Again po, kung may mga tanong po kayo, please message us either directly or by leaving a comment in our Facebook page, YouTube channel, TikTok, or Twitter.
Mm-hmm. And with that, let's go to the first question, Judge. Mm-hmm. From our kahuntahan, na itago na rin natin sa pangalang Maria. Mm-mm. Pwede raw bang ma-dismiss ang isang employee who refused to be vaccinated?
Oh, napaka-timing ng tanong ni Maria, di ba? Mm-hmm. Parang kinumbay niya, Attorney Al, yung episodes natin on human rights with Attorney R.P. Santiago and dismissals with Dean Ada Abad. Maria, I hope na napanood mo both episodes na yon, but if not yet, then you may watch them on our YouTube channel and Facebook page. Sa human rights episode with Attorney R.P., it was mentioned that there is no mandatory vaccination. Meanwhile, doon naman sa You're Fired episode namin with Dean Ada, no, we discussed about the lawful causes for dismissal, which can either be a just or authorized cause. With this in mind, then an employee who refuses to be vaccinated cannot be dismissed from employment. Hindi po kasi mako-consider na lawful order ang isang directive to be vaccinated since vaccination nga is not mandatory naman. Hence, ang isang empleyado po who refuses to follow a company directive to be vaccinated cannot be considered to be committing willful disobedience, which is a just cause for termination. Kasi po, yung willful disobedience, it presupposes that the order given is lawful and reasonable. At it pertains to the duties which the employee has been engaged to discharge. No? In fact, in the DOLE advisory, meron po tayo niya, number 3, Series of 2021, nakalagay po doon that while employers shall endeavor to encourage their employees to get vaccinated, meaning to say, parang i-suggest, i-recommend, na parang, oh, try mong kumbinsihin, i-engaño, yun, that's a proper word, i-engaño sila. Any employee naman who refuses or fails to be vaccinated shall not be discriminated against in terms of tenure, promotion, training, pay, and other benefits among others. Or, lalo na nga, hindi po siya pwedeng tanggalin sa trabaho. Mm-hmm. Bawal din po, mga kahuntahan, ang no vaccine, no work policy. Mm-hmm.
And with that, we hope that we have sufficiently answered your question, Maria. At sana ay maliwanag din po sa ating mga kahuntahan. Na for sure, no, yan ang naging concern nila nung mga nakaraang buwan. No?
Yes, kasi napaka-timely ng question niya. Now, Attorney Al, ikaw naman, ready ka na ba for our next question?
Hindi pa 100% pero may choice ba ako?
Wala. Kasi kailangan sagutin natin ito, no? So okay. Yung question naman para sa iyo is from our kahuntahan, unfortunately, ay naaksidente sa daan. Mm-hmm. Ito yung message niya na itago na lang natin sa pangalang Jenner na ipinadala rin niya through direct message sa ating Facebook page. Mm-hmm. Sabi niya, "Good evening po. Gusto ko lang magtanong, last Saturday around 9 p.m. po, naaksidente po kami ng asawa ko sa West Service Road ng Paranaque City. Pauwi na po kami ng asawa ko from work. Naaksidente po kami dahil nabangga namin ang barrier sa daan na wala man lang visible sign or caution sign, kahit neon man lang, para maabisuhan po ahead ang mga motorista kahit nasa malayo pa po ito. Sobrang daming pasa at sugat ang natamo po namin mag-asawa dahil pumailalim po kami sa malaking L300 truck type. Tanong ko lang po, if sino po bang pwede kong papanagutin o paano po yung proseso? Yung sa truck po kasi, sabi ng investigador, wala daw po silang kasalanan dahil hindi naman daw po kami binangga ng truck. Nagkataon lang daw po na sila ang kasunod na vehicle." Yun po yung message ni ni Sir Jenner. Now, Atty. Al, may mga dokumento ring pinadala si Mr. Jenner sa atin, although yung salaysay niya, hindi na niya pinadala.
Okay, thank you, Judge. Mr. Jenner, we hope na maayos na po kayo ng misis nyo. Maraming salamat sa pagtiwala at pinadalhan nyo kami ng mga dokumento tulad nung picture, nung larawan ng injury at ng police report.
Yes.
So, Mr. Jenner, itong sagot ko ay base sa police report.
Mm-hmm.
Ayon kasi sa investigation, yung plastic barrier ay inilagay sa kalsada para takpan ang isang pothole o malalim na lubak.
Mm-hmm.
Yung barrier ay warning sana sa mga motorista para maiwasan ang lubak.
Mm-hmm.
Unfortunately, ayon din sa police report, hindi nyo nakita yung barrier nung nag-overtake kayo dun sa L300 van na naging dahilan para sumemplang kayo at madaganan ng L300. It also is worth to mention na nagkaayos na pala kayo nung driver ng L300 matapos kayong bigyan ng pampa-ospital. So if that is the case, kung may amicable settlement na kayo, wala na po kayong habol dun sa driver ng L300. But I think dapat i-call natin ang attention ng mga in charge dun sa road repairs, whether national or local government.
That's right.
Ayon kasi sa Article 2189 ng ating Civil Code, provinces, cities, and municipalities shall be liable for damages for the death of or injuries suffered by a person by reason of the defective condition of roads, streets, bridges, public buildings, and other public works under their control or supervision. Yung paglagay ng barrier doon para takpan yung lubak is only a band-aid solution.
True.
Dapat regular ang pag-monitor sa mga kalsada at kung may mga ganyang mga barriers, dapat visible sa gabi at sa malayo para maiwasan agad. So yun lang masasabi ko dyan. Definitely this case, if it reaches the court, will be contentious kasi pwedeng ma-raise din ng kabila yung contributory negligence ng complainant.
Tama.
So, Judge, hanggang dun na lang muna, no? We hesitate kasi to make a definitive statement.
Tama.
Dapat kumonsulta po kayo, Mr. Jenner, sa isang abogado kung talagang nais niyong magsampa ng kaso.
Yun. Tama po yung sinabi ni Atty. Al at uulitin lang po namin na ang naging sagot po namin sa tanong is meant for legal information only, not advice po. Then, bukod pa doon, Atty. Al, no, meron din po tayong isang kahuntahan na itago na lang natin sa initials na JP. Na ang tanong naman niya is about small claims.
Oh, nice.
Doon din, direct message din sa ating Facebook page. Now, sinabi ko naman na natin kay JP via direct message din na antabayanan ng future episode natin on small claims. Lalo na nga at may bago tayong consolidated guidelines for first level courts na i-feature natin. Kasama doon yung small claims. Kaya JP, abangan nyo po ang episode na yan. And with that, Atty. Al, it's time to go to our topic at hand, ang mga karapatan ng LGBTQ+ community.
Yes.
While it will be better to discuss this in more detail with our special guest in our Amicus Curiae segment, we can also give an overview naman about this important topic in this particular segment. Hindi ba, Atty. Al?
Yes, Judge. At dahil dyan, magta-transform muna ako.
Ganun.
Simulan natin sa pagpapaliwanag ng konti kung ano nga ba ang ibig sabihin ng LGBTQ+ na ngayon. As per New York Times article, is now LGBTQIA+, which stands for lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender, questioning, also some refer this as queer, intersex, and ally. Yung plus sign naman daw is an acknowledgement that there are non-cisgender and non-straight identities that are not included in the acronym. This is a shorthand or umbrella term for all people who have yung tatawag na non-normative gender identity or sexual orientation.
Oh. Actually, Atty. Al, if we only had more time, maraming magandang pag-usapan pa about yun nga, yung kung ano ibig sabihin nun, pero siguro mas maganda i-discuss natin yan with our special guest later.
Yes.
At bukod pa ron, marami ring magandang pag-usapan at interesting facts about the LGBTQIA+ in Philippine history.
Yes.
At kasama na ron yung isang 2016 article from my favorite historian, si Ambeth Ocampo, dun sa column niya sa Philippine Daily Inquirer na Looking Back. Ang title ng article na yon ay Bringing LGBT Out of the Closet History.
Oh, yes.
Napakagandang basahin, no? At maganda sana pag-usapan. Pero for now, since limited ang ating time, let's discuss na about the rights of our LGBTQIA+ community. Now, hindi naman po lingid sa kalaman ng lahat na up to now, nakakaranas pa rin po ng diskriminasyon at prejudice ang ating LGBTQIA+ community due to various reasons, including lack of proper information. In fact, in a 2019 CNN article about the SOGI bill, no, the reaction and attitude of the country and the Filipinos to the LGBTQ plus community is aptly summarized to be tolerant but unaccepting. What's your view on that, Atty. Al?
Eh, biglang ako ang naging amicus curiae dito, ha. Host lang po tayo dito, guys. Pero anyway, that's a very difficult question. Mm-hmm. But yes, I have a parang position din on that, no?
Mm-hmm.
And I think there is truth to that statement that mm-hmm. Filipinos are tolerant but unaccepting of the LGBT.
Mm-hmm.
Look, many Filipinos tolerate or allow the existence or presence of LGBT in our society.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, kung may transgender na sumakay sa jeep, tahimik lang ang mga ibang pasahero.
Mm-mm.
Hindi nila binubu or hindi rin nila kinakantsawan.
Mm-mm.
They just stare and then look the other way.
Mm-mm.
Parang sige, bahala ka dyan.
Mm-hmm.
But then again, ibang usapin yung accepting the lifestyle or the gender expression of an LGBT person.
Mm-hmm.
Halimbawa, yung transgender na dinedma sa jeep,
mm-mm.
kung makikigamit na siya ng restroom ng babae kasi yun ang kanyang gender identity, ay siguradong madami ang may violent reaction.
Mm-mm.
Ang sasabihin ay, lalaki ka pa rin, pinanganak kang lalaki, hindi ka babae.
Itama.
You have no right to use a female restroom.
Mm-hmm.
Isa pa, halos tanggap na ang isang effeminate o malambot na lalaki, pero kung magjujowa na siya ng kapwa lalaki, ay itatakwil agad yan.
Oo.
So there lies the irony, if not the hypocrisy.
Mm-hmm.
We proclaim to be tolerant of LGBTs, yet we cannot accept them for what they are, for what they do, and for how they live. Diba, Judge?
Yun yan. Ako, well said, Atty. Al. Now, mga kahuntahan, parang ang, ano na eh, parang ikaw na yung amicus curiae natin. Pero napakang ganda na sinabi mo. Pero, yan po, mga kahuntahan, in that same CNN article which discussed about the SOGI, hindi po yung SOGI na iniinom, ha? The SOGI Equality Bill. Yung SOGI po, sexual orientation, gender identity, and expression. No? Yun po yung sabihin ng SOGI. And we have a bill on that. It is said to be the oldest pending bill since the year 2000 pa po yung original filing ng bill na ito. And the proposed law has yet to hurdle legislation pala. Sayang kasi maganda pa naman itong SOGI Equality Bill. As the Tatler article further discussed, the SOGI bill recognizes the fundamental rights of every person regardless of sex, gender, age, class, status, disability, religion, and political beliefs. Mm-hmm. This means that the law protects members of the LGBTQIA plus community, no, from discrimination and marginalization. Pero not only limited to them, because yun na nga, ang layunin naman ng SOGI bill is to be equal.
Correct.
To everyone. Diba? Yun yung recognition niyan. At dahil nga po, sobrang importante itong SOGI Equality Bill natin, mm-hmm. abangan nyo po yan, mga kahuntahan, sa isang separate episode natin.
That's right, Judge. Meanwhile, isa pang mainit na usapin to ko sa LGBTQIA plus community is with respect to marriage and civil unions.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, since election time na, isa yan sa paboritong tanong sa mga kandidato natin, specifically if they favor same-sex marriage or civil unions. Interestingly, Judge, our special guest himself filed a petition to remove the prohibitions against same-sex marriage under the Family Code of the Philippines. Kaya maganda pag-usapan yan mamaya with him as amicus curiae segment natin.
Mm-hmm.
Especially since his petition was dismissed only on procedural grounds, ha, but not on substantive grounds.
True, Atty. Al. Kaya looking forward ako sa discussion natin about that sa amicus curiae segment natin. In the meantime, I know na kahit na medyo running out of time na tayo, meron ka pang gustong i-share about this important topic.
Okay, di ba pala tapos sa aking pagiging pseudo amicus curiae.
Okay.
Actually, Judge Merrick, because you know, we teach the subject naman.
Mm-mm.
And I think this will clearly create some controversy.
Mm-hmm.
Related din ito dun sa disjunction between tolerance and acceptance. I mean, mm-hmm. we wish everyone to find that one true love, di ba?
Mm-mm.
Pero bakit may criterion ng sex o kasarian ang love?
Yeah.
A man has to choose a woman as his love and vice versa.
Mm-hmm.
Kung magkapareha sila ng kasarian, hindi daw love yun para sa iba.
Mm-hmm.
It is anything but. Kaya may double standard ang society at batas sa mga couples.
Mm-hmm.
We tolerate same-sex couples, yet we withhold from them the protection and benefits that opposite-sex couples enjoy.
Mm-hmm.
Halimbawa, may right of succession ang mga opposite-sex couples pero wala ang mga same-sex couples. May right of visitation sa hospital, sa kulungan, sa training,
yes.
ang mga opposite-sex couples pero wala ang mga same-sex couples.
True.
So if we proclaim that love is for everyone, then why do we discriminate? Yun lang, Judge.
Grabe, speechless ako. Ang galing talaga ni Attorney Al. Kaya talaga, ikaw isa ka sa pinaka-paborito kong abogado.
Grabe. At dahil dyan, friend talaga kita, Judge.
Oo, talaga naman.
Yeah. Anyway, that's all the time we have for our Legally Speaking segment. Pero mga kauntahan, the best is yet to come as we will surely have a more interesting discussion with our special guest in our Amicus Curiae segment. Yan ay sa pagbabalik ng
People's Court.
The information provided in this show does not and is not intended to constitute legal advice. Instead, all information and content in this show are for general informational purposes only. No viewer should act or refrain from acting on the basis of information provided in this show without first seeking legal advice from a proper counsel. No attorney-client relationship is created or intended to be created with the audience of the show.
Welcome back to People's Court or Amicus Curiae segment. Ako po ulit si former Judge Jing Uyenco Nolasco. At syempre pa po, hindi makukumpleto ang ating programa kung wala ang the one and only Atty. Al Jumrani na galing pang Boracay ito. Now, in our Amicus Curiae segment, we are glad to have as a friend of the People's Court for today's episode, a brilliant lawyer like you, Atty. Al, who can truly give more light on our topic. First time I met him, Atty. Al, was when we both acted as judges in a TV law school debate for another channel. Hindi ko nababanggitin kung saan.
Alam ko yan.
Basta yun. Yes. I was the chief adjudicator.
Sa Quezon City yan, di ba?
And he was naman a co-judge. So, tama ka doon sa Quezon City.
Ako, huwag kayo mag-debate mamaya, ah. Mag-debate kayo.
Hindi, magkasama ako sa panel. I remember na he was then just a new lawyer. Pero parang tanda ko, parang sinabi pa nga niya sa akin na the year before daw, kasama siya dun sa team ba? O yun. But I was really impressed with his intelligence kasi noon talagang handa siya. Ang dami niyang tanong dun sa mga nagdi-debate noon, no? So, Atty. Al, and yun yung mano. Kaya, tapos after that kasi, yun, we got in touch, yung Facebook friends kami. Kaya very happy to see him after all these years. Atty. Al, can you again do the honor of introducing our special guest for today?
With pleasure, Judge Jing. Kaya nga nung sinabi niyo sa akin na siya ating guest, sabi ko talaga, the?
Oo, the, diba?
Well, sasabi niya kasi infamous doon, but no. I'd rather say na the famous.
Ayan. Correct, totoo.
Okay, so our special guest is a civil rights activist, a public interest lawyer, formerly a lecturer at the Far Eastern University, and radio anchor at Radio 5, and currently a non-practicing lawyer. Mm-hmm. As a gay man, he questioned the definition of marriage excluding same-sex couples under the Family Code before the Supreme Court in 2015. Mm-hmm. He stood before the court en banc for 5 hours in 2018 during the oral arguments as the youngest lawyer at the age of 31 to ever have done so. In 2016, he was the lawyer for the Samahan ng Mga Progresibong Kabataan, the group that questioned the curfew ordinances of certain LGUs against minors before the Supreme Court. Mm-hmm. Kaya nung 2017, the court ruled in their favor and struck down the ordinances.
Galing.
Impressive, di ba?
Oh.
So without further ado, mga kauntahan, we welcome our special guest for today. After 2 years, is his first public appearance. Attorney Jesus Falcis III.
Yun.
Welcome po to the show, Attorney Jess.
Thank you for having me, sir. Ayan. Thank you for having me, Judge.
Ako, talagang thankful ako na nagpaunla ka sa aming invitasyon on this very important topic. Now, simulan na natin, Atty. Al, ang ating discussion para mas marami tayong makukur.
Okay, na-intimidate na ako.
No, huwag kang ma-intimidate.
Dali na nga mga hosts.
Simplihan lang
ginalingan namin.
Para kung nasa Supreme Court ulit.
Ganun ba?
Di ba? Justices.
Hindi, siya lang yun.
Future.
Okay, so ikaw na magsimula ng tanong.
All right. So, Attorney Jess, you were listening to our, sa Legally Speaking, we mentioned na ang label or ang term, yung umbrella term for this community is LGBTQIA+. Pero marami ang hindi nakakaintindi, lalo na for the longest time, ang ating label lang ay dalawa, lesbian or gay. But now there are several terms, several labels. So ano po ba yung mga letters dyan sa LGBTQIA+?
Kumbaga, in simple terms, paano ipapaliwanag
yun? So isa-isahin natin yung mga letters.
Hanggang
no?
LGBTQIA, tapos yung plus. Ayan, sige.
Go. L is for lesbian. Mm-hmm. So a lesbian is a woman who likes fellow women.
Okay. No?
So sexually, they're attracted to fellow women.
Okay.
And then gay is a man who is sexually attracted to a fellow man.
Mm-hmm.
Ang bisexual naman, and there are bisexuals talaga. Mm-hmm. No, kasi baka sa Philippines, no, alam nga natin may mga tao who doubt the existence of bisexuals. Right. So bisexuals are people who like or are attracted or can be attracted to either sex, mm-hmm. to man or a woman. Mm-hmm. So depende siguro kung how hot or the mm-hmm. situation. May ganon. So, okay. Bisexuals. T. T is for transgender. No? Ang transgender, sorry. Can either be a trans man or a trans woman. Ang trans man is someone who was biologically born as a woman or medically declared to be a woman.
Okay.
And we can discuss that later. No? But feels and knows in his heart that he is a man.
Okay.
So, a woman... born as a woman, but knows that he's
a man.
Mm. Trans man.
Mm.
So you transition to being a man.
Okay.
Trans woman naman is someone who was born a man, medically declared a man, who knows and believes that she is a woman.
Mm-hmm.
So I say she na kasi nga trans woman na.
Mm-hmm.
Oo. So we have Jake Zyrus as a trans man. We have Bibi Gandang Hari as an example of a trans woman.
Okay. Si Angie King.
Si Angie King, siya si formerly known as Ian King, no?
Yes, yung si Joey Mead, partner.
And partner ni Joey Mead. So, siya, trans woman siya.
Okay.
And si Angie King, tingnan natin later. Si Joey Mead, tingnan natin later.
Uh-oh.
How we can categorize her. Kasi
sabi niya,
she's still in a strong relationship, di ba?
Right. Sabi niya nga, lesbian daw siya. Angie because King. She's in love with a woman daw.
But she was also in love with Angie King when... She was a man.
Correct. Oh,
so, paano yon? Anyway, so that's transgender. It's about gender identity.
Okay.
LGBTQ. Q is questioning kanina sabi, but ako personally, I would, some people, most people call it questioning.
Mm-mm.
Personally, I categorize it as queer.
Mm-mm.
And activists would want to call it as queer, no? Kasi questioning kasi can be negative in connotation.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Na parang confused ka lang, you're correct. Just going through a phase.
Yeah. True.
No? But queer people know that they cannot be categorized.
Mm-hmm.
Yung kanilang gender identity, sexual orientation, and how they express themselves is very fluid, kumbaga. In fact, we can call Mayor Sara Duterte or we can categorize her as queer, no?
Okay.
But she's the one who can really say it.
Uh-huh.
But with her recent statements na when she wants to be a man, she cuts her hair short.
Uh-huh.
And when she wants to be a woman, she grows her hair to be a woman. But she's in a relationship. She has a husband. Na lawyer din. And then, you know, her general feminine expressions usually feminine, no? Except during a certain time na parang mas bruce ko siya. Because she was under a Duterte administration in Davao. So baka ganun yung upbringing niya.
Mm-mm.
But with her statement, we can see na she doesn't wanna be boxed under na babae lang ako, lalaki ako. Or she can try to be or she wants to try to be a man.
Mm-mm.
With her statement. Ha? So that's queer. Kasi there's no certain category that we can box her in. She's not definitely lesbian.
Mm-hmm.
She may be, but she hasn't said that, diba? Mm-hmm. But even if she was lesbian, yung expression din niya, very fluid.
Correct.
She wants to be a man or a woman. Hindi siya like si Angie King, si Bibi Gandang Hari, or si Jake Cyrus. Eto na ako. Na I believe I'm comfortable being a man or a woman, yung mga nag-trans. Siya, mas fluid. Parang she can change her hair to suit her needs or desires. So that's queer. Because a queer person is someone who is non-conformist when it comes to gender stereotypes or traditional gender roles.
Right.
Being a man and a woman, being masculine or feminine.
Okay.
So that's queer. LGBTQI, so we're an I is for intersex.
Intersex
is a person who has non-traditional medical condition from a traditional man and a traditional woman. So bear with us, no, dun sa mga nakikinig. Being a man po kasi, so ako, I know I'm a man. I'm gay, but I don't want to be a woman and I don't think of myself as a woman. And as a man, the reason why I'm a man and I'm not intersex din is because medically, my chromosomes, so that's one, are XY. Some people can have XXY.
Correct.
A woman kasi traditionally, ang chromosomes niya XX. Yes. So if you're not XX or XY, you're outside of that. You're already intersex.
Okay.
The other is hormonal balance. So men usually mas receptive sa testosterone.
Yes.
Our bodies naturally produce more testosterone and we respond to it. Women generally produce more estrogen. And their bodies are receptive to it. I'm simplifying it. There are many hormones.
Correct.
I'm not a doctor. We're just lawyers who know a lot in other fields. So if you're a man but you're more receptive to estrogen, or maybe your body produced more estrogen, you might have more feminine features such as bigger hips or bigger chest. That looks like
woman.
Female breasts. And so sila, intersex sila because in terms of their hormones, hindi sila traditionally a man or traditionally a woman. Ang woman naman na mas madaming testosterone can also have broad shoulders. Hindi siya yung glass R shape. Magiging ano naman siya, yung V shape na lalaki. Ganun. But she's a woman. And she's also comfortable as a woman. So intersex yun.
Attorney, sa mga hindi nakaalam na sa intersex, is this the same as hermaphrodism?
Yes, for the older generation. That is how they would categorize it. But now the correct term is intersex. Because hermaphrodite or hermaphrodism only encapsulated yung genitalia.
I see. Okay.
Kasi nga, kanina sabi ko, medically speaking, when a baby is born, the doctors declare it either to be a boy or a girl.
Based on the external genitalia.
Based on the external genitalia. Yes. May penis ba or wala? Boy yan or girl.
True.
But now we know based on science. So this is not gawa-gawa lang, di ba? And hindi naman mali din yung older generation. It's just that the science has progressed. And
so
we know more.
Hindi na limited.
Correct. And from the Bible, di ba? Sa Bible kasi, ganun lang din. What was visibly seen. But now there are more behind what makes you a boy or a girl. Your hormones, your chromosomes, your genes. Hindi naman yan nakikita nun. So yun, yung external genitalia, that's also another factor that makes you intersex. You might have both genitalia. That happens as well.
Yes.
But that's external. May internal din tayo. The ovary and the testes or the balls for guys. Or for women, for may ovary, you can have both then.
Yes.
So, if that's the case, ano ka? So, ang category nun is intersex. Because you do not fall under a traditional man or a traditional woman's body. We're talking about physiological, anatomical. You don't fall that under the traditional archetype. So, that's intersex.
Okay.
Madami pa. It's, you know, I mean, it's very medical.
True.
It's not for us siguro to dive deep into that. LGBTQIA, ang A naman is asexual.
Okay.
And like bisexuals, totoo din na may asexual. Baka kasi sabihin ng mga iba, lalo na yung mga magulang nila, asexual, hindi mo lang nami-meet yung
tama. Right one for you.
Or, sama kita sa bar, pumunta tayo sa club. I'm sure, maano ka din doon. Kaya yung mga all-boys club na. Or yung babae naman, kailangan, you have to be a woman. We'll make you a woman. Dadalhin somewhere to get good times. Kumbaga, no? Pero may mga tao talaga who are not attracted to anyone. Or, it's not their priority. Parang hindi din sila talaga interested in exploring their sexuality. Maybe baka hindi nga nila nakita pa yung tamang tao, but we cannot invalidate and say na, gawa-gawa mo lang yan.
Hindi pa lang.
If they say na wala silang experience and then 20, 30 plus na sila, di ba? Who are we to say na hindi, mayroon ka talagang gusto, hindi mo lang sinasabi. Diba? Baka wala talaga siyang type.
Tapos yung plus.
That's asexual. And then plus is because we're learning more and more, science is progressing, there are more categories or more sexual orientations, gender identity and gender expression that may not be covered under LGBTQIA. So that will fall under the
So yes, kasama doon yung pan, pansexual.
Pansexual, sapiosexual, yung atlante daw sa matalino, hindi nila tinitingnan yung looks.
Yes.
Pag narinig nila yung magsalita or pag narinig nila yung ideas, doon sila kikiligin.
May kinikilig kaya sa akin.
Madaming kinikilig dito sa People's Court for sure. Ang mga viewers ng People's Court nanonood lang nito kasi ano din sila. They wanna experience kanang see this intellectual orgasm.
Oh, yeah.
That's my favorite.
Oh, intellectual orgasm.
Na-mention nyo kanina, Judge, yung debate, di ba? That's all about intellectual, ano.
Orgasm,
correct.
So, ngayon na medyo malinaw na sa ating mga kahuntahan itong LGBTQIA+. Of course, actually, marami pa nga yan. Dapat pa natin pag-usapan. Punta tayo ngayon dun sa ano sa tingin mo ni Jess Falcis, kasi nga 'di ba kanina nabanggit namin yung sa Soji Bill, pero yung kasi bill pa lang ngayon, ano ba yung summary, no, para sa ating mga kahuntahan as a member of the LGBTQIA+ community and as a lawyer, yung mga essential rights and duties sa palagay mo ng
that we already have or we do not and we should have?
Pareho. You have, tapos dapat meron din tayo. Kasi pa-segue tayo dun sa mamaya, di-discuss pa natin yung tungkol yung sa petition.
So, generally, LGBTs have the same rights as other people, as the majority. So, dun tayo sa wala.
Okay.
Para mas clear, no? Kung ano yung wala. So, yung SOGI Bill kasi, anti-discrimination law, ang isang core nun related dun sa previous episode nyo about workers' rights, anti-discrimination in the workplace. So, in the workplace kasi, right now, you can be hired or fired on the basis of discrimination. Na parang, ay, mukha kang trans or trans ka, I don't wanna hire you. Or hindi ka din ipopromote. Hanggang dyan ka lang kasi hindi ka bagay dito sa top management. That's discrimination kasi it doesn't look at your skill. Your management skills, accounting ka, cashier, kung gaano kagaling gumawa ng chicken, fried chicken. Diba? That's discrimination. And that is addressed by the SOGI Bill. Where employers, even if they have management prerogative, will now be penalized or punished if they discriminate on the basis of SOGI, which is sexual orientation, gender identity, and gender expression. Has this happened? I have to say yes. I have to mention the company kasi that's the example, no? We have the example of a trans activist, si Bunny Kadag, na was not hired by Jollibee. Unfortunately, noon pa naman to, and I think they have made steps to address this. But it's not that public kung ano yung steps they made to address this, no? But Bunny Kadug was not hired. And sa kwento niya, it was because she was trans.
So anong nangyari? Kasi nga, yun yung i-follow-up question ko rin. Since this is already happening, at kanina lang kakwentuhan namin si Bielka, ako special mention si Bielka, tungkol dun sa nangyari sa friend niya, na ganun din, na 2018 yata, parang sa mga special children kasi, yung kaibigan niya na psychologist ito, no, Bielka, na trans ba? O yun, trans. Tapos parang hindi hinire dahil daw baka daw magkaroon ng ibang impression yung mga bata na dapat lang daw kasi babae o lalaki. Tapos ang itsura niya daw kasi iba yung buhok, iba pa na namit, hindi siya hinire. So,
sad.
Given yung gantong situation, ano, since wala pa nga tayo ng SOGI Equality Bill, how is this kind of situation addressed? Pati yung nangyari kay Bunny, for example.
So for now, they do not have the rights under the labor code to file a case na ano yun, unjust or what, walang concept sa labor code. If ever meron silang remedy, it would be a local remedy sa ordinance. Because meron ng mga local government units that have passed an anti-discrimination ordinance. Where employers cannot discriminate on the basis of sexual orientation or gender identity. So, in that case, yung 2018, I think mas onti pa yung mga LGUs na may anti-discrimination ordinance. Unfortunately, walang remedy. Unless nga yung LGU noon ay meron. From what I know, Iloilo, Cebu, Quezon City, yun yung mga mas may anti-discrimination ordinances. So, so for the viewers, they have to check their local government unit, and madali namang i-google to, googleable, which cities or municipalities have an anti-discrimination ordinance. So yun, wala silang remedy.
Kaya importante talaga itong SOGI Equality Bill na sana maipasa na kasi ang tagal na nito.
Yung sa SOGI Bill ba, Attorney Jess, would that, if it were passed back then when you filed the case before the Supreme Court, the landmark case, no, Do you think that would have affected the decision of the Supreme Court in that case? Or kahit hindi na yung decision na yun, but would we be more open to same-sex marriage leading to maybe the amendment of the family code or even a refabrication of or the calibration of our decisions on the concept of marriage?
I would say no, no.
Hindi pa rin.
Sir, kasi noon, when the SOGI bill was being crafted, there were clear no-go zones for the legislators.
Okay.
They have to clarify that the SOGI bill does not legalize or will not lead to the legalization of same-sex marriage because may mga congressmen and senators who were influenced by bishops or on their own based on their religious beliefs na think it will lead to. So the progressive congressmen and senators had to clarify na this is totally independent or not related to same-sex marriage.
Okay.
That's why also I had to file the case. Because since natanong nyo na, the LGBT movement for a long time in the Philippines is only pushing for the anti-discrimination bill and not for same-sex marriage because in their view, it is a more explosive or controversial discussion which they will not achieve anything down and will harm the more important, and I put this because I think both are equally important, the more important cause daw, which is anti-discrimination. So that's why I had to file because I needed to push for this advocacy because I think they're complementary.
True.
In fact, they're complementary. They are not related or intertwined na one will lead to the other. Kung may same-sex marriage, will it lead to anti-discrimination law? No, not necessarily. Vice versa, ganun din. Anti-discrimination will not lead to same-sex marriage if the Congress if Congress passes it. But they're complementary because as you said, attorney, na yung it will help normalize values and perception and acceptance. No, because we all know the law is normative. If there's a law, people have to follow it and will ask, why is this the law? So we'll get to know the reasons behind why this should be how we behave. Law regulates that. So yun ang belief ko sa same-sex marriage. If there's same-sex marriage, the youth, even the old people, no, but especially the youth will learn na it's important to have couple rights, to have rights in the relationship, that they are accepted. So the values get normalized.
So yun, ayun, okay. So lahat doon nga nabanggit mo kay Attorney Al, kasi gusto ko i-relate doon sa yun nga sa petition for same-sex marriage. Like for example, nagkaroon na tayo ng ganun. Yung like sabi mo nga yung mga rights na meron ang mga
same-sex couples. Opposite sex couples.
Yung mga heterosexual sex couples. Pagka may ganun, you think Attorney Jess, no, yung mga nabanggit ni Attorney Al kanina na wala, na mga wala sa same-sex couples, na meron sa opposite sex couples, ma-address yun pagka nagkaroon itong sa, yun na nga, no, ng pagbabago, same-sex marriage.
Definitely. Yeah. With the petition, if we go to Congress, they will have modifications or tweaks, which I think, in a sense, will probably still give lesser rights to same-sex couples. Because even now, ang discussion natin is civil unions only for same-sex couples. No, but we all know, and this is to clarify to the religious people, walang matatapakang religious belief. No church will be forced to marry gay couples if they don't believe it. Because may mga churches then who believe it. Non-Orthodox churches, metropolitan community churches. These are Christian churches, not Catholic. When we say Christian, kasi Christianity is the religion naman talaga, and Catholicism is just one branch. So, there are strands of Christianity or Christianism that support same-sex marriage. Kasi wala naman sa Bible, it's not clear in the Bible. But that's a long discussion. So anyway, what I mean is, the petition I filed, because it is through the courts and not through legislation, the court will be forced to declare everything equal.
Okay. I see.
And so, that's my belief na pag Congress kasi, baka they might lessen the rights given to same-sex couples. Sa petition, the court will just strike down na, okay, everything is that is afforded to opposite sex couples, to straight people,
kailangan
is afforded now to gay couples.
Correct.
So yun lang ang gagawin nila.
So, meron ang right to obligations. parental authority.
Familial connection, yes, which is the most important. What I emphasize nung oral arguments and what everybody should remember, why same-sex couples are really fighting for same-sex marriage, mm-hmm, or the LGBT movement is fighting for it, is because under the law, and this is in the United States, but this is a good thing for us to adopt as well, the magic, mm-hmm, of marriage is that it transforms strangers into family.
True.
There is no other tool. There's no other magic wand.
Yes.
There is no other law that allows two strangers not related by blood, mm-mm, to be called a family. So, kung hindi kayo kasal, di ba, walang concept ng father-in-law, mother-in-law, mm-mm, husband and wife na family unit na sila. Mm-mm. They cannot testify against each other in court, di ba, judge?
Yes.
They have spousal privilege. Mm-mm. Madaming ibang privilege to be a family.
Mm-mm.
If you're two strangers, you have no rights. And just to give an example, this pandemic, noong 2020 at the height of the alpha variant ng COVID-19, no, which was very lethal, thank God, now, no, mas okay ang ating situation, may gay couple na yung partner niya namatay.
Uh-oh.
And nung namatay, because of COVID restrictions, di ba, had to be cremated.
Mm-hmm.
And then, of course, yung restrictions on who will get the body,
yes,
from the hospital, and yung authorization, release, yes, letter, tapos yung QC government handling the cremation,
mm-mm,
hindi ka pwedeng private cremation lang, mm-mm, kailangan assisted by the government for COVID-19 restriction purposes, hindi niya makuha yung body,
mm-mm,
yung gay partner. Kasi wala siyang legal rights. He's not considered as family. Let's make it alive. Paano kung buhay? Comatose? Or may cancer,
mm-mm,
wala siyang legal right to be in the hospital, mm-mm, in the, yes, hospital room. The doctor technically can say, who are you?
Mm-mm.
You have to be outside the room. I'm sorry. Worse, what if the family does, mm-mm, not accept and say, palayasin niyo yan yung partner. So,
that's really sad.
He's not in the room. E paano kung nakakomatose yung partner and the partner actually ang kanyang wishes and is, under the law,
yes,
we should respect the person's wishes, di ba?
Right.
Even after they're dead. What if ang gusto niya palang kahawak inside,
yes,
the hospital room
yung gay partner niya
is the partner.
Mm.
He loves the family.
Correct.
He or she loves his family, his parents. Pero gusto niya nandun yung partner. But the family did not accept. So wala siyang legal right to insist na I should be in this room. Kahit awkward, nandiyan yung kanyang mga manugang, pero andun din siya, kahit awkward.
It is really sad. No? But that's the reality. And as you have said nga, hopefully that petition could have changed things, but then maybe it was not the right time. But
change does not happen naman overnight.
Exactly.
Yeah, so meron pa kasi yun namang petition na yun was dismissed on
no procedural grounds naman.
Grounds. So pwede pa. Meron pang
and we have to start early.
Yeah.
Because the United States, they actually started in the 1970s.
So
they lost in 1970.
Correct.
They only won in 2015.
Correct. That's
so baka mga later on, pwede pa.
Correct.
It requires 40 years, imagine.
Exactly.
A generation, two generations.
Correct.
Ang dami pa.
Ang dami pa. Grabe, bakit kasi bitin talaga oras.
Kasi ang daming, napafascinate ako, nakaganyan ako. So.
Correct. And I'm sure our audience was also fascinated by that fruitful and colorful discussion we had today. Yun nga lang, we have to adjourn na naman due to lack of material time.
Parang court na court.
Correct.
At sa words ni Judge Jing, another Gloria Estefan moment.
Mm-mm.
Because time really flies so fast pag interesting and discussion. Di ba, Judge Jing?
Ako, so through Atty. Alex, sabi ko nga, na-fascinate ako kanina kay Atty. Jess, talaga nakaganon lang ako. Pero I like the modification that you made ha doon sa Gloria Estefan na yun ha. Na, pero alam mo, mas maganda talaga. Kantahin mo ulit, Atty.
Ayoko. Wala na time, Judge. And if I remember from our episode with Judge Selma Alaras, di ba ikaw yung may utang na kanta?
Okay, kumanta na ako yung episode natin with Court and Raul. Pero anyway, talagang wala na tayong oras, so we have to go. Maraming salamat ulit, Atty. Jess, for accepting our invitation. At yun nga, for a very fruitful, at sabi nga ni Atty. Al, colorful discussion. So, ulitin ha.
Invite thank you for inviting me, Judge. Thank you for inviting me, Attorney.
Thank you
I
very
enjoyed
much.
The discussion as well.
Thank you very much, Attorney Jess. Pero more than that, maybe you want to leave some parting words for our kauntahan.
Well, mas makulay po ang buhay kapag kasama ang LGBT. The color of the LGBT and our symbol is the rainbow. And mas makulay po ang buhay kung tatanggapin po natin ang ating kapwa LGBT.
Nice, ayan.
Maganda.
So nice. Hi, Mom, Dad. Mm. Alam niyo na, ha?
Hi, Mom, Dad na.
Maraming salamat uli, Atty. Jess. And with that, thank you po, mga kauntahan, for supporting People's Court and for joining us today. Sana po ay marami kayong natutunan and that you feel more empowered now. Ako po muli ang inyong kauntahan, Atty. Al Jumrani. Till our next episode.
Thank you ulit, Atty. Jess. At ako naman po ulit, mga kauntahan, si former Judge Jing Uyenco Nolasco. Maraming salamat po sa inyong ulit lahat, no, mga kauntahan. Patuloy niyo pong subaybayan ang ating programang For the People, By the People, of the People. This is the
People's Court.
Abraham.